here. Thank you so much for being here today. I am so happy to be here, and I hope that you're happy to be here as well. So today's video is just about a yearly or every other year. I think it's yearly though video that I do. And if you've been around for a while, you'll know exactly what this is, or if, I guess if you can read, you can tell from the title. But today is going to be an unboxing and kind of a first initial thoughts of the brand new Apple iPhone 12 Pro Max. Okay, so this is the one that just came out on like the 12th, I think. I can't remember the exact day, but the Pro came out and then the Max came out, and so this is the 12 Pro Max. All right, so we're gonna unbox it and get some nice sounds, and then I'll have some like just initial thoughts on it, I guess, and that'll be it. But yeah, I enjoy doing these videos a lot. I do them. I think I've had every iPhone since the iPhone 4S, actually. And yes, I'm an Apple sheep. Yes, I get every phone that comes out. Yes, let's just get that out of the way. I know there'll be a lot of comments of like, oh, you're so spoiled, blah, blah, blah. Who cares? Who cares? I literally get these phones because I like them, okay? But also to do a video with, okay? So just relax, okay? After all, that is indeed the point of ASMR, all right? So anyway, I hope that you enjoy. I think we'll do an unboxing first. And then I actually have a couple other accessories as well to unbox for the phone. All right, so stick around. Thank you so much for being here. And let's get into it. All right, so let's get right into the video. I think first things first is we'll just get some tapping on the box before I do the magical plastic removal. Okay, because I think it'll sound different with and without the plastic. I think just initially, if you've been around, you know I'm a product packaging guy. I think I've said that in every iPhone video. Someone make a highlight video of me saying that. Anyway, noticeably, the first difference with the box is, it's thin. It's very thin. Okay, normally they're like easily that high. Okay, and the reason that it is so thin is, I suppose, a controversial kind of thing, but also, you know, we don't have to get into it, but basically it does not come with the USB-C wall part, the cube, as they used to call it. So it just comes with the phone and the USB-C to lightning cable, which just me as an Apple snob, I wish it would have been USB-C to USB-C, but that's okay. Lightning is perfectly fine. But yeah, it does not come with the wall adapter, which, like, you know, clearly Apple wants you to go buy the wall charger if you don't have it. Fortunately, I have a few of them, I think, so it's not a big deal to me. And I think that what Apple always does is, one, they'll always try to sell you on an accessory, no question. But also, I think that they assume a lot of the people getting phone, like, I think that their assumption is that the people getting a new phone had the last one, or maybe skipped one and had the one before that. Instead of thinking, hey, the people buying this phone is going to I can see both sides of it. Like, it's weird to not be like, imagine if you just got this phone and you had no idea you couldn't charge it. You know what I mean? So I get that. I get that. I'm just saying, I worked there for 2 years at Apple, and I know their mindset. And so, I don't know. I can only speak for me and personally. Stuff. Okay, so let's do a little bit of tapping without the plastic before we open it. All right. Oh yeah, see, it's much different. It's definitely more direct and less kind of plastic snappy sounds, if you will. This is the best sound. Easily the best sound. So if you don't know yet, my favorite triggers are phone tapping. Phone box tapping is up there. It really is. Listen. Oh yeah. It sounds like rain. I think that's what it is. Rain on like a window. What color I got. This is the 256 gig version. But I get matte black everything. Like all of my stuff is matte black. It's my favorite. But I thought, like, I don't know. It was like a game time decision of like, I think I want to switch it up. So I ordered the silver. So there is the back. I'm gonna try to do it with no fingerprints here. Of the iPhone 12 Pro Max. This is very exciting. Okay, I am very, very excited. So we're gonna take it out of the box here, okay? Just give you some views of it really quick, of it in the box. Okay, and I like this because it's a matte silver, so it kind of looks white on the back, so I really like that. It's just kind of a, you know, a change from the matte black that I always get. So I'm going to take it out of the box, and we'll talk about it, all right? So here we go. So, very clean. Look, you can see me there. All right, so, very clean. Wow. I can't believe I have this in my hand right now. It's very exciting. Very, very exciting. Okay, so let's talk about the phone really quick. All right, Apple, or if any Apple fans or anything see this, I understand that I'm one of the only people that open up a brand new phone that's like, I don't even know how much it is. It's like $1,100 or something. And I tap on the screen first thing. I understand. But that's what we're doing. All right. So 256 gig iPhone 12 Pro Max in silver. All right. So let's talk about, let's get into some nerdy specs real quick. The screen, I'm trying to hold it at an angle so you don't get my light. The screen is actually made of a new material. Before, it's been Gorilla Glass for quite a long time. And this, they named this the Ceramic Shield Screen. It is ceramic shield. Okay. Who knows what that means? Okay. So, like I said, the back is a matte silver, but it looks, there you go, but it looks white, honestly. Like, it looks white. Okay. And then the sides are stainless steel. Now, here's the only thing, is that it looks fantastic. Like, it's all shiny. And the sides, the stainless steel sides are fantastic and it looks amazing. The only downside, though, is fingerprints. Okay, so watch. So if I'm holding the phone, just, you know, looking at things and look. Hopefully you can see. Do you see how it shows fingerprints? So, I don't love that, okay? But, one of the accessories that I'll open after, should take care of that, okay? But, yeah, so I don't know. Design, I love the design. It looks amazing, but the fingerprints don't look great. Okay, that's okay. Okay, so, this is a, should we turn it on? Yeah, let's turn it on. Here we go. Here we go. I'm so corny. Okay. Okay, so it's turning on. So the screen is a 6.7 super retina XDR display. Enormous screen. It does still have the notch, which I don't mind. In fact, I kind of like it because it makes it feel it's in the center. I don't know. I like it. But it is a 6.7 Super Retina XDR display, which is an enormous screen. Super Retina is an OLED display at 2778 by 1284 resolution. Okay. It is a 2,000,000:1 contrast ratio. So, yeah, the screen is fantastic. And it's huge. Like, I have an enormous head. And so, yeah, 2,000,000:1 contrast ratio. The size of the actual phone itself is this here is 6.33 inches, okay, by 3.7 inches by 0.29 inches, okay, and it weighs 8.3 ounces, all right, so I can already tell you from just holding it that it does feel a little bit heavier and a little bit like sturdier, if you will, and I love that. By the way, I like when there's a little bit of weight to it, and it feels sturdy. It feels, I don't know, sturdy. That's the only way I can think to say it. Let's see what else. I will say, like, the screen is so big that, like, it's hard to do. Like, I can barely touch the top. You know what I mean? So, just trying to give an honest review here. It is water resistant with an IP68 rating, which means, I think it's like 60 meters underwater for, what, like a half an hour or something like that. So, I wouldn't necessarily call it, again, waterproof, but an IP68 rating is very good for being water resistant. Okay, so I hope they don't see this, but I traded in my 11 Pro Max, and when I was at the beach, I put my phone down like this, and I was taking a time lapse of the ocean, and the tide came in, and my phone was in the ocean for like at least 20 seconds underwater. And when I turned my phone in, they did a check. They did the diagnostic check and said that there was no water damage. So, yeah. If sometimes, like, I'll be listening to a podcast or music or something. So, you know, anyway, one of their big selling points was the battery. And it has 20 hours of video playback and 80 hours of audio playback, which is fantastic. It comes with iOS 14, which is fantastic. I love iOS 14. I had it on the 11. I love 14. I'm a big fan. So, my God, it is pouring. Do you guys hear that? Crazy. Okay, so, what else? The Mac, oh. Let me open one of the accessories. Okay, so one of the new accessories that I'm really excited about is the MagSafe charger. Okay, so if you know anything about Apple computers, for the most part, you'll know what MagSafe is. But I'm actually really excited for this. So I'll show you the little diagram, but basically it's just a charger disc, if you will. But let's open it up because I want to see it in real life and also see how I want to test how magnetic it is. With the most popular camera in the world, obviously, is the iPhone or cell phones in general. And there is certain differences between the Pro and the Pro Max. I, of course, just try to always get the best possible one, just because I use my phone for my job. Of course, I don't film on it, but for all of the social medias and everything else I have to do, I use the phone. Okay, so the camera's a big deal for me. So as a Pro 12 megapixel system, okay, with the ultra wide, and the telephoto lens. So that's those three. Okay. The ultra wide is an f 2.4 aperture, with smart HDR, and the photos are. I've watched some here. Let's see if I can get into the phone here. Okay. Well, I don't want to mess up the setup, but the smart HDR photos look amazing. I've already watched some reviews on it, and the I think most people have it as the most consistent and best camera out of in a phone. Of course, everyone will always argue that with some of the Galaxy phones, I'm guessing, or even some of the Google phones have like crazy megapixels. But I think functionality wise too, it's just my favorite. So, you know, all those other phones are amazing too. I've used the S20 just like in a video, and it's an incredible phone. Like, I have nothing against it. It's just all of, for me, all of the products, like the watch and the computer and everything, it's the ecosystem. Okay, super snob way to say it. Okay, so the thing I'm most excited about with this phone is the video. So it shoots HDR video at 60 frames, of course, but it is the only phone on the market, only phone ever, I think ever, it's gotta be, to shoot video in Dolby Vision. Dolby Vision, okay? And Dolby Vision is incredible, and it is a format of video file, I believe, but it is, just look it up, you'll see. But I'm very excited to test the video on this phone. Very excited. You know, they're always going to make the camera a little bit better. Every phone is just, they're just going to make it better. Okay, so this is the screen. Okay, and then this is the back. It's matte silver instead of a shiny or dark silver. I love that it's matte. Super clean, I think. Okay, so the other accessory that I'll put on this, like I said, that's going to fix the bumper issue with the fingerprints is I got the iPhone 12 Pro Max clear case. Okay, so essentially it's just a, you know, case that's clear, and the reason I got the clear is, you know, I'm excited to have what looks like the white iPhone with the silver, and you know, if you get a case, that doesn't really matter, but the clear case, you can still see everything, and it's still protective, and it's also, I don't know if you'll be able to see, there we go, it's also MagSafe compatible, so I can have the phone. Have the phone with the case on it, and the MagSafe will still stick through the case, so I love that. These are also always great sounds, all the accessories. there's actually a white. Whoa, I did not know that. Okay, here. Whoa, I was not expecting that. That's kind of cool. Wow, that's crazy. Okay, so the case actually has the circle on the back for the MagSafe as a design. That's cool. I didn't know it had that. So that's cool. Okay, so let me clean off the fingerprints here. Hopefully. And we will put that case on. Here we go. I love it. So then see how you can still see the bumpers and the color. But it's in the clear case. See that? Oh, I actually really like the circle in the back. That's so cool. Okay, so initial thoughts. This feels good. Again, a little heavy, heavier than the 11 Pro Max, of course. But it feels sturdy, and I like that a lot. So that is the case. And let me grab the MagSafe charger again and we'll see if it works. Okay, moment of truth. So it's supposed to work through the case. Here's what I was thinking about doing, though. First of all, we're like 30 minutes in, so I don't know how many of you are still here, but if you watched till the end, comment the apple. How about that? Just the apple emoji. If you would like to see a iPhone 12 Pro Max versus the 11 Pro Max video, if you want like a comparison. That might be cool. Wow, this is cool. I like it. I really like. I actually really like the color a lot with the case. That's nice. Okay, so that's gonna do it for today's video. You know I had to do it. You know I had to. So shout out to Apple for not sponsoring me, and that's okay, but also for making a cool product that I love unboxing. Alright, so thank you so much for watching. Let me know if you are interested in getting it. Let me know what your thoughts are. I'm sure there's going to be a lot of negative in the comments as well. That's okay. We don't have to agree on the phone thing. It's always a big drama thing, but just like what you like, and I like these, so yeah, just like what you like. All right, but until next time, I am Matty Tingles. Good night.